Good morning, and welcome to the graduation ceremony for Cohort 6 of our Go Teacher Scholars. Please rise for the national anthem. Thank you, and please remain standing for the Ecuadorian national anthem.
Thank you.
Thank you. You may be seated. Congratulations. As you reflect on this very important day, I hope you focus on how much you have learned and grown, both personally and professionally. First, you're not returning to Ecuador the same as when you arrived in the United States. Think back to your arrival in Manhattan, Kansas. It was cold, you were in an unfamiliar place, new people, and about to embark on a professional journey that you could not quite conceptualize. How very brave each and every one of you were. Everything was unfamiliar, but think now to today. It's warmer, so that's good. You know your way around Kansas State University in Manhattan, Kansas. You've tried foods you liked, and probably some new foods you didn't like quite so much. But everything you have experienced as a Go teacher represents the dash between those 2 days. Your arrival at Kansas State University, and now as we celebrate your departure. Those two dates will forever be etched on your heart and your mind as impactful to the person and the professional you are today. Think about your first classes. Submersion in English was hard. You had to think constantly. I had one of my kindergarten students tell me one day that his brain hurt. I was making him think so hard. And I imagine that's how many of you felt as you were concentrating and really devoted to your learning. But think about the ending of your classes. Assignments may have still been quite rigorous. But you now understand methodology and assessment. You know the power of connecting with the individual students in your classrooms and learning about their lives and families. And you're ready to return to Ecuador, ready and prepared to impact those lives. That drives us in the College of Education, making a positive impact on the lives of children and families. We're proud of the impact that Kansas State University is collaborating with you to make in your country. And we're honored to be learning with you in this journey. There are many people that help facilitate a program as large as Go Teacher. And so it's now my honor to introduce Dr. Sue Mays, Dean of our global campus and a founding partner in the Go Teacher program. Please welcome my friend and colleague, Dean Mays.
First, I want to start by saying that I want to thank you for placing your trust in Kansas State University. K-State's helped you step through a journey to make you become an exemplary teacher. That trust you put in us to come from your home made you step out of your comfort zone, as Debbie mentioned, country of pizza and hamburgers and sub sandwiches. A country of football. No, not your fast-paced soccer football, but that slow American football where, in your words, they take all afternoon huddling and discussing versus that constant action up and down the field of soccer. But we'll be watching because we believe someday Ecuador is going to win that World Cup in the years to come. You saw a country of new faces, a country where friends were made through paired buddies. New families, some of them are here today, new homes, new churches. You made strong connections to American teachers in your classrooms at K-State and throughout the Manhattan community. But possibly most importantly, look next to you, you've made new friends among the teachers here with Go Teacher. They'll be with you in Ecuador when you return. In just a few days, you'll be reunited with those old friends that you left behind. In Ecuador, those families who will be waiting with you, for you with high expectations, probably tears in their eyes, and love for your return. My second comments go out to you as teachers and to those in the audience who have been your teachers. I want to salute you as teachers and to all the teachers in this room. This is a very hard, intense program. The teachers at Kansas State came into your classroom with rigorous assignments and expectations. They dedicated countless hours in and out of the classroom making sure you achieved the goals of this program, your personal goals, and the high expectations of your country and President Carrera. Through these 9 months of hard work, you will now transfer that learning and that energy back to your own classroom. The new learning you obtained as a GO teacher will be a tremendous boost to Ecuador and its future. Through Global Campus, we hoped you enjoyed a few cultural ventures, the Kansas Sampler Foundation Festival, where you got a glimpse into the pride of Kansas communities across the state when you went to Wamego. You went in all the little booths of all the little towns showing off their pride, whether it was their best apple pie or a statue you should see if you come to their community. We're glad you got to experience Kansas all in one place. You went to the 4th of July where you had the opportunity to bond with Dorothy and the Wizard of Oz and learn about her red shoes and how she clicked those red shoes and she could return to Kansas. Hopefully you'll have an imaginary pair of red shoes to take home so someday you too can return to Kansas. And you saw dazzling fireworks. Then of course, probably the one that's gonna be most in your mind is that Legend Shopping Center where you went, and I don't need to comment on the excitement of all those American stores to choose from. What I do hope, I truly hope, is that your suitcases won't explode when you attempt to snap the latches and zip the zippers this week. I wish you a lot of luck. You have people in the audience from American Airlines, so they're well prepared about knowing those big suitcases that are going to come. I also hoped you enjoyed your venture to the University of Kansas, where you sat as peers with Kansas teachers from across the state learning together. I sincerely believe you had the best opportunity Kansas State provides to students. I know of no other program that puts in this type of intense effort, joins the many offices on campus to work together to achieve the high quality the GO Teacher program has come to represent. I wish you a safe journey. I expect via Dr. Carrera to hear amazing accomplishments to come from you over your entire career as teachers of Ecuadorian learners. A cartoon comes to mind where a doctor is looking at an x-ray and pointing out to the patient this very large heart. And the caption reads under it, "Your heart is slightly bigger than the average human heart, but that's because you're a teacher." I want to end with my own personal goal, and that is to see the Galapagos blue-footed booby up close and personal, and maybe I'll see you too. I'd like to take the opportunity to introduce Grant Chapman. Grant is the Assistant Provost of the Office of International Programs. Grant.
Well, congratulations to the GO Teacher participants, Cohort 6. Particularly congratulations on behalf of the Office of International Programs, and in particular, the English Language Program. You may not realize, but you probably do, what an accomplishment developing a non-native language is. And I know personally how hard that is. About 25 years ago, I spent about 9 months in Brussels, and I was very confident in my French before I went to Brussels, and having to study, in this case, law, in the French language, but also then try to communicate in a Dutch or Flemish language along the way, I realized how limited I was, and then how lucky I was to be immersed in the language and culture, and how lucky I was to improve every day just by living that day in that particular culture. So I want to congratulate you on developing your non-native language skills. I also want to congratulate you in living, learning, and studying in a different country. That is never easy. You're outside of your comfort zone, as was mentioned earlier. And the ability to be outside one's comfort zone, but yet make friends, survive the food, the climate, and understand a little bit more about the commonalities that all of us have around the world. And instead of focusing on the differences, as many of the media and social media outlets do. Truly, your hard work is in a unique program. And this program at Kansas State University is such a collaboration of multiple units and colleges. The Global Campus, the College of Education, the Center for Intercultural and Multilingual Advocacy, the Office of International Programs, the English Language Program, the Office of International Student and Scholar Services, and the Office of International Admissions and Recruitment. So all of these units came together under the leadership of the Global Campus and College of Education to provide this program for you. And we're very proud to be part of that collaboration. As part of the program started in 2012, as a partnership between Kansas State University, Ecuador's Minister of Education, and Ecuador's governing body, we have sought Kansas State to prepare you to interact, and I'm quoting from actually your website, so thank you for that, to interact in an intensive English learning environment situated in a native English-speaking context and achieve advanced levels of English competency to support their teaching of English to studies in Ecuador. The third goal is to understand the methodology and pedagogy to be successful teachers in the classroom. I want to mention that this program really echoes the land-grant mission of Kansas State University. So from the 19th century to the 20th century and now through the 21st century, land-grant universities, one of the missions is outreach and extension. And at first, it was outreach and extension to the local county, to the state of Kansas. But now in the 21st century, this is an example of outreach and extension around the world. So this particular program does fit within the heritage, the culture, and the mission of Kansas State University, which is very important. In order to make a couple of the goals, our English program faculty, staff, and administrators have sought to make sure that you have achieved, and just as you have worked hard inside and outside, the English language program courses to achieve your goals. The ELP faculty, staff, and administrators worked hard to prepare and teach these courses. Now I'd like to recognize and thank all of the ELP faculty, staff, and administrators. So thank you all for the excellent teaching. Thank you. But remember, this is a two-way street. And so I want to thank you, the participants. You have made this campus of almost 2,000 international students. You have added international culture to Kansas State University. Your interactions with students, with staff, and with faculty enrich us, enrich Kansas State University. So while I know that you have received much instruction and developed your languages and skills, Kansas State University has received the wealth of your culture, the discussions with you about world problems, the discussions with you about your country, and that has informed the campus the last semester and through the summer. So I do want to thank you for that, those experiences on behalf of our students, our faculty, our staff, too. Now, most importantly, this is the day and time for you to celebrate your accomplishments at the end of your program. And again, I congratulate you. I ask, though, a few things from you. First, don't forget us at K-State, as we will surely not forget you. Second, tell others in Ecuador about your time at K-State, in Manhattan, in Kansas, and in the Midwest, and particularly share your experiences with those who may be less fortunate enough, or not fortunate to have the ability to travel to the U.S. if they wanted to. And please share your experiences with your fellow Ecuadorians about the United States. Third, use the language acquisition skills you developed to assist your fellow Ecuadorians, and I know you will, in the classroom with your students and outside the classroom. And make sure you talk not only about the development of your English language, but basically your cross-cultural communication skills and the items you learned about methodology and pedagogy. Finally, and most importantly, enjoy today and travel home safely, but we hope to see you back. Thank you. And now I have the honor and privilege of introducing our next speaker, Dr. Socorro Herrera, Executive Director of the Center for Intercultural and Multilingual Advocacy and Professor in the College of Education. Thank you.
Como toda Latina traigo los tacones, aunque it would have been nicer to have the flat shoes, right? Bueno, primero, I've got to see if Jennifer's going to put the PowerPoint, because keeping with being a faculty member, we're always teaching, so we need the PowerPoint. You know, the title of what I want to talk to you about just briefly is Developing Stars, because I think that among you, there are stars, stars that will rise and keep rising from this point forward. You'll rise in the classroom, you'll rise in the work that you do in advocacy. You know, in your classes you talk about advocacy. Abogar por los niños, nuestras familias, nuestra profesión. Y la pregunta que quiero que se lleven con sí mismos en todo eso is, what comes first, the art or the science of teaching? Porque la ciencia es muy fácil aprenderla. Todo el tiempo le digo a los maestros, if you want to learn the science of teaching, take a class or buy some books and read them. If you want to prepare to be good with the art of teaching, look into your heart. Look into your heart and ask yourself, what do I do in the classroom that shines? What conditions do I set in the classroom that prepare all students? Ustedes saben que en sus mismas clases, unos días no se sentían como que querían participar. You know, you went to class and you were like, I haven't slept, I had more pizza and I have diarrhea, you know, or this is really boring. And what did the teacher have to do? They had to look for new ways of motivating you and engaging you and looking for ways to love you, because sometimes it's not easy to love every student. I want you to think, just reflect just for a minute on the classes that you took and the teachers that you had, just for about, I mean, it's going to be actually like 60 seconds, and think of the art that they brought each and every day and what it is that engaged you, and then think of the science, what it is that they were doing in order to get you where they needed you to be on that day. So Jen, go ahead and show them the little video clip. Or the little slideshow.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying how do you do?
So think for a minute what it took in all of those instances to take another step. Because I'm going to start with the Boys and Girls Club. In the Boys and Girls Club, every single day, Jen, you can go to the next slide. It's, every single day that you guys came back, there was one person who was, I'm not getting what I need, you know, or gosh, I had a wonderful time. I was playing soccer. And so we're in all of your work, anytime you're involved with human interaction, you're going to have the ups and the rock bottom, and the ups and the rock bottom. What you have to remember is that when we work in situations where we're working with human beings, con el ser humano, todos los días va a ser una de caída y subida y caída y subida. Lo que tiene uno que encontrar, como les dije cuando primero llegaron, is that you have to find the humor, the passion, and the determination. You have to find joy in anything and everything you do. Cuando el alumno le dice uno, muévete para acá, y te dice, chinga tu madre. We have to find humor in that. We have to say, well, I wonder why he's there today. Because students will be there. You were there in some of the classes where the teacher said, we're going to work in groups. Oh, we're going to have so much. We're going to practice our English. And you rolled your eyes. You sighed. You kicked the chair when you moved. And we're adults. Imagine that. Imagine when we go back to our children who may come hungry or may have things going on at home. In what ways will you find that humor in what it is that they do and find the determination in your soul and in your heart? Because there's no science that teaches you how to not say, pues la tuya. You know, there is nothing in our life that doesn't make us want to turn right around and give the student back what they gave us. But rather what we do is we find that passion that we have for moving the student forward, that human element, that love, that art, and we continue to try, and then we leave and we go home and we collapse and we wonder why we're teachers every single day. Because after all, we don't get paid enough. We don't get paid enough. We get students who aren't with us. But for all of us that are developing stars, for all of us that like to move teaching and learning forward, we put together what it is that we need in order to achieve. Go to the next one, Jen. Jen. Okay. Oh, who can tell me what this is? This is a test. What's this called? The U-curve. Wherever you might be on the U-curve, because I know that some of you are still in the hostility stage. I know you never left the hustle stage. Maybe it's because you don't have el cuy. Les va a hacer falta el cuy. You want to go have your cuy, and no matter what we did in classroom or went to Legends, or you still just want to go home. Think about those of you, though, who are now at the last stage of all of this. Think of you who have now become, not only increased your English proficiency, but also have become bicultural. When you go home, when you get back to Cuenca and Baños and Quito and all of those places, you will look back and your heart will ache. You will hurt because you will wish that you were here. Not because you want to leave your family and you want to have more pizza or Subway or any of that, but because you have left behind part of your heart. With all of these individuals here, you have left something that you will want to keep. And when anyone from here goes there, you will be excited to share your country and to relive part of what you left behind. Think about, go to the next slide, Jen. I guess I should do a thumbs up and then that would be a cue. Think that when people come together and they enter into conversation and they learn from one another, those relationships form and we begin to think and act upon the world in a little bit different way. Each and every one of you will never be the same in the classroom. Even those of you who leave still thinking, I didn't get what I came here for. I didn't get what I came here for. What I'm going to tell you, though, that as you leave, I know that you take away from you. See, it's my thumbs up now. I know that you take away with you the art of being able to create a product with your students together. I know that you take away the art of how to develop language, not because the curriculum works or doesn't work, but because you know what it is that you need to do. I know that you will look at your students in a different way and that you will explore the experiences and their life circumstances and that you will reach out to try to move them forward without judgment. I know that you will challenge them even if they roll their eyes at you and kick the chair. And I know that you will always teach through conversation, that it won't be a book and a pencil and a repeat after me. Go to the next one. So now as you leave from Manhattan and go back to Ecuador, we at Kansas State University, because you are not the first group, know that when we go into your classrooms in the future, we will see beauty, we will see art, and we will see science. But more than anything, we will see the joy in students' faces as they participate in learning with you. I want you to watch this video, because as you sit here today, you go, oh, estas cosas que me enseñaron aquí no van a servir para nada, porque Correa tiene una meta diferente, porque el director de mi escuela no le gusta esto, porque a mí no me gustaron estas estrategias, no me gustó esto, no me cayó muy mal, no me... So you will have all the why nots. However, we have been in over 400 classrooms. Those people at CIMA have gone to classrooms all across Ecuador. I want you to look for a minute at the faces of the students. Forget the teachers, but look at the students and what it is that you see and ask yourself, what will I do when I go back to my home country? Okay, so if you think of the pictures that you saw of yourself in the classroom and you see the pictures of students in classrooms in Ecuador, what do you see? You see joy in your students' faces. It doesn't matter if you're teaching preschool, kindergarten, first grade, seventh grade, science, math, a university class. In all classrooms, the art of teaching, the ability to engage and to have students interact and to have students stay with you and to motivate the student who does not want to do those things. Because it's much easier to go back to the straight rows and write this down and, you know, be very linear. But what you want to think about is, in what ways will I practice the art, and what do I take away that's a science? And combining those will make you the stars that will move forward for years to come. I want to end with a collection of statements that I have picked up from Los Angeles to New York to China to Guatemala to Paraguay to every place that I've been. Because I always say to teachers, why do you stay with this? I say to the SEMA instructors when they come back and have had a not so good time in class. And we had some of those instances, remember? I went in and talked. I ask the question, why do you stay in teaching? And I think it's a question that you'll have to ask yourself, because you'll have all sorts of opportunities. You've been in the United States for 7 months. You go back with a high English proficiency. It would be much better as the tourism opens over there on the beach for you to go lay on the beach and talk to the tourists, right? But why is it that we stay with teaching? Let's look at these statements that people have made over time. No 2 days that you ever teach will ever be the same. Ever. Just keep going, Jen. What does it mean to have hope in the future? Right now, your country's in turmoil. We're here, and they're having the protest, and we should be over there seeing what's going to happen, right? Correa's having a cup of coffee, though. He's not worried. I've been following that. I'm very interested in you know, where it's going to go just because of the commentaries. But teaching gives us hope that no matter the turmoil, no matter the changes, that we do something for the students that leave us and that they leave better than they came. We have passion for social justice. I hope that each and every one of you leaves with the ideal that everyone deserves and has the right to an education, to have access to learning. Not because you're going to become rich, but because you can have a democracy and you can make decisions about what's best for you, for your family, and for the world around us. Because we believe in caring and empowerment. I don't know, some of you, I don't know, you may not care too much, but I know you believe in empowerment. Son los hombres los que no tienen mucho corazón. Más porque las mujeres son las que apoyamos más. Because we love building community. Because kids help us think beyond. Because we have a mission. Because we are risk takers. We believe that everything is possible. Because we know what is possible. But most importantly, it's because we are about human relationships. And so with that, I want to leave you, and I want to go to the next slide. And I want the individuals here from ELP and SEMA to stand up. Stand up if you taught, or if you counseled, or if you held a hand, or if you, all the things. And where's Sarah Thurston? I saw her. Where's Sarah? Where are you? She just walked out. Sarah just walked out. These individuals here are heroes. One, because bringing 66, 64, 100 students from Ecuador and having a seventh-month program is not easy. Because looking to transform the ideals that are deeply embedded in our heart because of our culture and the way we've been prepared, it's not easy. Everyone? It's not easy. It's not easy. And regardless of what happened day to day, what downs we might have had, each and every one of these individuals stayed the course and led you to where you are today, or guided you to where you are today. So I want to give them a huge round of applause for staying the course. And building the relationships that will last a lifetime. So I know that each and every one of them will be forever grateful that you have touched their lives, that you have taught them, and that you will invite them to Ecuador so they can eat some cuy. Okay? So thank you very much. It's not a goodbye for any of us, because I know that Ecuador is in our heart and will keep calling us from now and forever. So thank you very much for listening to me for a whole 20 minutes. I like to talk more than they do, so here I am, and I like to have a PowerPoint, so thank you. Now, I'm going to invite a wonder... Párate, Reina. doing that. I want to thank this young lady. Renata has been the core of this group. She has the heart of a hero, of a star, of an amazing person in each and every way. Throughout the whole entire 7 months, she's taken on the task of taking everyone's pains and joys and doing something with them. She's always smiled. She's never given up. We've had some tough times, haven't we? We have had some really tough times in this group. And she has always, with a smile and always with patience, because I'm not always available, she has always taken whatever needs to be addressed and very professionally and very respectfully has presented the information and kept talking, has never raised her voice, has never acted frustrated, although I know that I frustrated her sometimes because I wouldn't give her the answers that she needed. I will forever appreciate your professionalism, your humanness, and the way that you have cared for this group. So she would like to do a few closing statements. So Renata, it's your turn.
Hi, everyone. I'm very, very happy to be here. I have prepared some words, especially for all of you and for my co-teachers. Dear colleagues, professor, and friends, we have completed this training period. We came here with a goal, and we have accomplished it together. First, I want to thank God, because thanks to him, we could start and finish this stage. Teachers and authorities, thank you on behalf of all GO teachers for giving us their support, their time, their knowledge, and thanks, friends, because you have been our family away from home. So thank you very much. Thanks to each of you for putting that seed in our heart that I'm sure will flourish. This is what it is about from now on for us, to serve others and to show a good attitude toward what we can do. Attitude is our signature and says who we really are. The attitude of all the above has given us the example to be well with our students in Ecuador. So I want to say that you are an example for us. Someone once told me, life is like riding a bicycle. To keep your balance, you must keep moving. I am encouraged, as I know you are, to go into this battle, putting all my strength and heart, effort and courage with eyes toward others for change. Then the victory will be ours, because we are showing the same thing we learned here. This time will not have been in vain. Then the victory will be ours, because we are showing the same thing that we have learned here. As Gandhi said, be the change. You must be the change you want to see in the world. Let's inspire, be passionate and full of love. Now we're going back to Ecuador, stronger and with different eyes. Let's act like true warriors. We're not the same as we came. Let's show how strong we have become and not be afraid, because God and all the people present are with us. We are the generation that is committed to change and responsibility, that our country can witness what we have in our heart. As Aristotle said, educating the mind without educating the heart is not education at all. We have been privileged out of many. We were chosen to go and bear fruit, and the fruit should remain. So, dear GO teachers, Go to the nations. Go to Ecuador. Go to the youth. Go shine and impact lives. Go teachers, we finally did it. Thank you.
Go teachers, please come forward when your name is called. Cristian Antonio Álava Palma. María Rosario Álava Zambrano. Marcia Nelly Álvarez Vázquez. Araceli Estefanía Arciniega Chalá. Yandri Vanessa Ávila Jaramillo. Eliana Esperanza Benavides Vaca. Jimena Alexandra Benítez Vaca. Carlos Efraín Bonilla Pazmiño. Sandra Isabel Burgos Sosa. Esther Elizabeth Cabello Franco. Paulina Elizabeth Cabrera Buri. María Eugenia Calderón García. Renata Maria Cañas Albornoz. Marco Santiago Carrillo Yepes. Silvio Roberto Carrión Sánchez. Oscar Fabián Carrión Toro. Segundo Heriberto Casacumba Pila. Rosa Elizabeth Castillo Ramírez. Félix Raúl Chávez Armijos. Marlene del Rocío Chuluisa Chacón. Sara Azalia Delgado Vera. Mary Mercedes Díaz Bacasela. Aida Gladys Espinosa Tanicuchi. Patricia Natalie Espinosa Castro. Marlon Vinicio Freire Romero. Sandro Paul Gaibor Gómez. Javier Israel García Chasipanta. Adán Arturo Gómez Pachana. Marta Angelina González Párraga. Solange Elizabeth Guerrero Rodríguez. Tioclia Noemi Guerrero Villasnay. Diego Armando Jaramillo Guamán. Jorge Hamilton Leal Ceballos. Jimena Janet Janes Coronel. Carla Liliana López Valladares. Cristian Javier Maywa Mayanquer. Rodrigo Javier Manzano Pérez. Diana Natalie Mendieta Alvarez. Jacqueline Alexandra Mendoza Alaba. Tatiana Soledad Morocho Ventemilla. José Miguel Narváez Arango. Glenda Jacqueline Navarro Hermenegildo. Lilian Catalina Nievesela Guamán Rigra. Miriam del Carmes Núñez Sánchez. Susana Elizabeth Ortiz Ortega. Nitzia Margarita Pérez Logroño. Luz Amada Porras Cortés. Gabriela Margarita Ramírez Casco. Heidi Lilia Rivera Rivera. Carlos Eduardo Rojas Pérez. Yvonne Lisette Romero Bermeo. Jimmy Silverio Sánchez Castro. Tatiana del Rocío Sandoval Coca. Berta Rocío Sukushanyay Quintuña. Mercy Lucía Tuapanta Chancusic. Edwin Vladimir Tuapanta Yumikinga. Lucía Marisol Tuapanta Yumikinga. María José Torres Bedón. Romina Alejandra Torres Juña. Hugo Fernando Trujillo Larcos. Gladys Viviana Vaca Pérez. Jimena Marisol Ventimiglia Bautista. Miriam Matilde Velázquez Galarza. Carlos Eduardo Villacres Encarnación. María Luisa Vire Quesada. And Elizabeth Jacqueline Zambrano Acosta.
Let's give one more round of applause for all of our Go Teacher completers. Congratulations, today is your day. You're off to great places, you're off and away. You have brains in your head, and you have feet in your shoes, and you can steer yourself any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know. This is just the beginning of a book by Dr. Seuss, a famous children's author, entitled, Oh, the Places You'll Go, and we often quote it at commencement ceremonies. As we conclude today, I would like to thank Dr. Socorro Herrera and her instructional team, everyone from the Office of International Programs and our English Language Program and our global campus for their tireless support to make this program beneficial for each of you. They believe in you and they know you will impact lives. As your experience at Kansas State University draws to a close, think about the future. First, the impact you will make. I like the visual of a pebble dropping into a pool of water. Think about your future classrooms, your school, your community, and your country. Second, think about your own continued learning goals. This isn't the end. It's just part of your professional journey. You've completed a rigorous professional development sequence of courses, and I challenge you to think about what's next in your professional learning journey. We thank you for teaching and learning with us. Our lives have been enriched because you chose to come to Kansas State University. We're saddened by your departure, but thrilled that you will soon be back with family and friends. So, oh, the places you'll go, and will you succeed? You will indeed, 98.75% guaranteed, you'll move mountains. So, be your name Bixman or Bixby or Bray or Mordecai, Ollie, Van Allen or O'Shea, you're off to great places. Today is your day. Your mountain is waiting, so get on your way. I've quoted from Dr. Seuss, and I truly believe you will have a positive impact on the lives of children in Ecuador. Thank you for embarking on a brave journey and for committing to learning and growing and dedicating yourself to positively impacting your country. Remember Kansas State University. We use the word family a great deal here. You will always be part of the Purple family. So when you're in Ecuador, wear your purple with pride, tell them about your experience at K-State, and please stay in touch. As we conclude today's ceremony, I am going to ask the GO teachers to come up on the risers so we can have one final photograph of the entire Cohort 6 group. And then we'll recess to the foyer right outside, where there will be refreshments and you'll be able to visit with the GO teachers personally. Thank all of you for coming and spending your morning with us today, and for the impact each and every one of you in the audience has had on the professional journey of our Cohort 6 GO teachers. Thank you.